I'm here with Magda Harbour and Dr. Emma Sloan from the Sloan Clinics. So we're going to be talking about phobias this time around. So social phobias, which is a fairly new concept to me. Emma, we'll start with you. So what's a social phobia?
Okay, so phobias as a collective. Most people, when they think about phobias, will think about arachnophobia, like spiders, or they'll talk about, you know, flying, their fear of flying or fear of water. These are the kind of very common phobias. And actually, as a GP, I don't often see these phobias coming to me in practice, unless it's sort of to prescribe some Valium for a flight or something along those lines. But what I'm seeing really predominantly, a growing trend, is social phobia, which is basically, it straddles all aspects of a person's life, wherever they go out into a social area, such as work, or school, or within a family, or socially, they feel a real sense of fear and anxiety build in them. So much so that they can have panic attacks, they can have physical symptoms like sweating, heart racing, feeling sick and faint. So we're seeing a lot more of this sort of social phobia rearing in the public domain now.
Yeah, okay. So Magda, what's behind that then? Is it a common phenomenon or...?
There is no common phenomenon. Right. I think that we're all born living in the society and then entering the society with the fear of being exposed. Exposed to criticism, exposed to other people's opinions, to be excluded.
Yeah.
Our primary function is to be in the group to survive. Now, any criticism and exclusion of the group will actually be very dangerous for us and for our survival. So that's instinctive.
Yeah.
We will all feel that. And with the new media, exposure, schools, that obviously is even more dominant at the moment in our society. But a phobic response to the social situation, very often its root is in a trauma, early life trauma, overcritical by the parents, maybe divorce, maybe illness of the parent, hospitalization, accident, any type of form of trauma. Well, for the child, could be something really small.
Yeah.
Could be seen as very traumatic.
Yeah.
So that's a root of, mostly this is a root of the phobic response.
Yeah. Can you just get a social phobia overnight? Is it like, you know, one night you're going to the cinema and then the next day you can't actually go to the supermarket? Or is it something that develops over time?
I believe that both. I believe that, yes, you can overnight. If you experience a traumatic event, being criticised, exposed, being put in the spotlight, and you experience an embarrassment, then that's a very firm possibility here to be phobically responsive to the next similar trigger.
Yeah. And that's, I've seen that as well, where somebody's been harassed at work and actually the harassment is so constant or the bullying is so constant that it wears down on their self-confidence, self-esteem. It starts to overspill into their home lives. They get very, very stressed and anxious. They start to get panic attacks and then they start to fear going out and being in social situations. And as a GP, it can be difficult to treat, except with sort of anti-anxiety medication, such as an antidepressant or a benzodiazepine. But really, that's where a psychotherapist like Magda comes into the game, because there she can actually treat the underlying psychological root cause of these of this social phobia or this anxiety.
Yeah. So how do we, people have to kind of go back into their childhood, don't they, often? Or is that just a myth?
It is a little bit of the myth, yes. I think that we would like to think that it's all in a childhood and we have to bring everything from the time. Actually, therapy doesn't work like that. We don't have to do it. Sometimes, yes, sometimes it's important to do extra, but we can always go just to do the initial trauma. We can find the initial trauma and work with it, not necessarily in going back even to the trauma. Sometimes we're working symbolically.
Anything to add at all?
Yeah, I think there is help out there.
Yeah. Yes, there is a help out there, and our main point here today is to encourage everyone to talk about it, to come, to ask, to chat. Most of the time, a psychotherapist will offer the free initial consultation. So yeah. What is there to lose to try?
Okay, Magda, great message. Thanks for coming in, Emma and Magda. Speak to you again soon. Thanks.
Thank you.